Let's see what's the role of zero. You know, in your on your number line, when you have a number line on your number line, we have learned positive, you know, positive numbers and negative numbers. We have integers like 1, 2, 3. So you know 1, 2, 3 if they are positive numbers. I think in our last class or something, we talked about oppositeness, right? Did we discuss about oppositeness? Hey, all of you, did we discuss oppositeness in our last class? Did we?
I think we did.
I think we talked about something like good. If there is good in this world, there is bad in this world.
Oh, okay.
Did we talk about east and west? Did we discuss this in the last class?
Yeah, we did, right?
So like that, I also talked about give and take, if you remember.
I don't remember.
So, okay, no problem. So basically, we have oppositeness. We didn't. Kavya says we didn't. So I will go with Kavya because Kavya is very attentive in the class all the time. Good, Kavya. I take it.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. So good and bad, east and west, give and take. When I say give and take, so let's assume I have some 10 chocolates with me. I give 10 chocolates to Kavya. Will she be happy?
I mean, it matters. How many chocolates do you have for day, Kavya?
Yeah. So let me call, you know, giving 10 chocolates as plus 10, right? Now, imagine I take away chocolates from some child. There's a young child on the street. You know, he's happy with his 10
That's
chocolates in his hand.
That's sadistic. You can't take it any
other time. I want you to understand that. That's the reason I'm taking it. Definitely, I'm not going to take it. But he'll be so
upset.
Yeah. So he'll be very sad. So
but
sad
sir, I
here.
Would be happy.
So happy versus sad. Sad is a negative thing. So it's minus 10. So we always have oppositeness in our lives. Plus and minus, positive and negative. So like that. In the number line also, everything on the right-hand side of zero, if it is positive, everything on the left-hand side of it is negative. So that's the biggest role our zero is going to play. So zero plays that neutral role to that positive and negative. That's the
so
first
sir,
thing that I...
They practically imagine that positive is there and like negative is night. It's practically between it. It's practically between that. And also if you imagine as a positive is summer or negative is winter, it's like, you know the middle line which is drawn between those two, right? Like zero is that middle
correct.
Line.
Correct, correct. Yeah, makes sense. I take that point, take that point. Wonderful. So
wait,
let's come to... Yeah,
sorry,
yeah. Arjun, let's not digress because we need to focus. We need to get a lot of concepts right. Yeah, concentrate now.
Yeah.
Now, coming to rational numbers also. So if we have a rational number, say plus 2 by 3, we have a minus rational number, which is negative of it is minus 2 by 3. So what I need you to understand is a positive rational number plus this negative rational number. If you add a positive rational number and the same value with a negative, that will always give you 0. That will always give you 0. So you are... So here you need
but
to understand.
Cancel out each other.
Yeah.
Like the plus and
minus. Perfect. So it's like this. If you have a positive 2, you know minus 2 as an integer plus 2. Minus 2 plus 2 is 0. Similarly, your minus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3 it will actually result in giving you 0. Minus 4 by 3 plus 4 by 3 will give you 0. There is nothing great to explain, but I need you to understand this fundamentally. So that leads us to a very interesting point. We'll come to that point a little later. Okay, let me go there first. So there's something called in rational numbers, we learn what is called an additive inverse. Now, what is an additive inverse? So zero is basically, you know, what is happening in addition. So we have a rational number, any rational, say, let's assume we have a rational number here. And that rational number, if I add with another rational number, right, if that gives you 0, can I say that this is, these two are of opposite sign. Can I say that? If I have a rational number, some rational number x and another rational number y, if that x plus y is equal to 0, can I say that from here it actually tells you that x is equal to minus y? Can I say that? If x, this rational number, one rational number plus the other rational number, if it is 0, if it adds up to 0, can I say that x plus y is 0, therefore x is equal to minus y? That means if you have 2 by 3 as one rational number, minus 2 by 3 is the other rational number. If it is 4 by 5, then the other one, it is minus 4 by 5. So this makes you learn a very interesting term. If someone asks you, what is the additive inverse? Additive inverse. Now, additive inverse is nothing but a number that makes the number when added. Additive is talking about addition, inverse of it. So additive inverse of 4 by 5 is minus 4 by 5. So additive inverse of, someone asks you, what is additive inverse of minus 3 by 7? Now, what is that we add to minus 3 by 7 to make it 0? We add 3 by 7. So it's minus of minus 3 by 7, therefore 3 by 7. So any number that adds up to the other number to give, so any rational number adds up to the other rational number to give it 0. So this is additive inverse of this number, and this is additive inverse of this number. And, you know, they are additive inverse to each other. So numbers adding up to give you 0, they are called additive inverse. Do you understand what I'm trying to say?
Yes, sir. So basically what you're trying to say is one number and the exact same number except in negative form is when added is 0.
Yes. So why it is called additive inverse, I'll explain that also here. So in, you know, if the role of a 0, so 0 is actually called additive identity. In mathematics, additive identity. So it is, it, you know, what it means is, if, for example, if you have an integer, say, for example, 2, what do you do to 2? What is the number that you should add to 2 to make it 2 once again? So give you the same number. So if we have 4, what is that should be added to 4 to give the same number? Say, for example, if I have a rational number 2 by 3, what is the number that should be added to make, give you the same rational number? So it's a, yes. So that word that is connected, what is that number that should be added? That is 0. You know, for any number, if you add 0, it will give you the same number. So it's called additive identity. So it's called, identity is the word that's given to it. So what I'm trying to tell you, what is the additive identity? It's always 0. Now let's come to, you'll understand more. Just give me some time. So similarly, role of 1. Now if you look at role of 1, any number, say for example 2 multiplied with what will give you the same number 2? What is the number 1 by 3 multiplied with what number will give you the same number 1 by 3?
1.
1. So 1, the role of 1 is, 1 is known as multiplicative identity. It's called multiplicative identity. I need all of you to understand this. So, you know, any number when multiplied gives the same number. So what is that number that you need to multiply? 1. 1 plays the role of a multiplicative identity, and 0 plays the role of a additive identity. Can I assume that you will remember this for your lifetime, all of you?
Yes.
Yeah? Yeah? Brilliant. Brilliant. Now that leads me to explain you something interesting. So additive inverse. Now tell me multiplicative inverse. Now what do you mean by multiplicative inverse? So if I have a rational number 2 by 3, what is that I need to multiply this number with to get 1? Now here I want a multiplicative inverse. What is multiplicative identity? Is 1. So to get multiplicative identity, what should I multiply 2 by 3 with? Very good, Naisha. Wonderful. I should multiply 2 by 3 with 3 by 2 to make it equal to 1. So if I have a number 4 by 5, what is the number I should multiply to give it 1? So I should multiply with 5 by 4. So that, yes, that will get cancelled and will give you 1. So to get multiplicative identity, you need multiplicative inverse. So to get additive identity, you require additive inverse. So that's what we have learned. So for example, if you have A by B, if you have A by B as a rational number, the multiplicative inverse of it is nothing but B by A. Because when A by B is multiplied with B by A, you get 1. So I want you to understand for that multiplicative inverse of any rational number A by B is B by A. I hope you're getting it. I hope you're getting it, all of you. So, yeah, very good. Very good. Let me go back once again. Let me go back. So what we have learned of zero. Zero plays a role of additive identity in our number system. It plays a role of additive identity in our number system. And today we are learning rational numbers. Even in the context of rational numbers, it plays a role of a additive identity. So now, similarly, role of one. Yeah, Alex, go ahead. Okay, so multiplicative identity, role of one plays a role of multiplicative identity.